We're in a very remote area between Dundee and Monroe in Raisinville Township along the Raisin River. It's where the little girl's body was buried. The River Raisin is quiet here with very little current, but this peaceful scene also provides evidence to a murder mystery.
You're dealing with somebody that I don't believe can be rehabilitated.
This is the quiet bend in the Raisin River where the body was found. The gravesite dug here. They dug the hole, put the body in, and then the quickcrete on top, the concrete. Not only is the little girl buried here, but also clues which lead to the killer. When investigators uncovered the little girl, she was nude, her clothes buried with her, the clothes Nevaeh Buchanan wore when she disappeared. The grave also included a Bush beer can. Sources tell Fox 2 the FBI traced this can to a market. The can of beer, they say, was sold at the High Life supermarket in Monroe. The owner says he's not aware of anyone shopping here who could be connected to the girl's abduction. Nevaeh's mom admits to a dating relationship with George Kennedy, a convicted sex offender. He remains in custody but is not charged with the girl's murder. Near Kennedy's motel room, around the back, a concrete company investigators found concrete covering the little girl's grave. People who live nearby pray at the riverbank where they discovered the grave of the little girl.
The guy was here before. He was here before.
Daniel Lovett frequently fishes and hikes along the River Raisin.
It wasn't somebody just driving by. He knew this spot, and he came here before. But his ignorance is probably what's going to keep him caught, because everyone comes down here, walks basically over top of where he buried her.
And Lovett says this river and this area has been changed forever.
We rent canoes, you know, and just come down here just for something to do, man. It's, you know, but now every time you come down this river, you'll always remember what laid right there. Always. You'll never forget it.
The FBI and the Monroe County Sheriff are investigating. Somebody may have seen something that seemed insignificant but could help crack this case wide open. In Raisinville Township between Monroe and Dundee, Ron Savage, Fox 2 News.
Those who love Nevaeh are bracing themselves for what could be the worst possible news. A positive ID on the body could take some time. Fox 2's Roop Raj joins us live in Monroe County. Roop, it's hard to imagine what the family is going through right now.
That is very true, Hugh, all because of people behind me never imagined that they'd have to deal with what they're dealing with right now. We're talking about friends and family of Nevaeh Buchanan holding vigil, holding out hope each and every night. This is no different than the last 11 nights, this being night number 12. Now just waiting on DNA results to come back.
Bring it back to biblical times. Set them out in the courtyard and let's stone them. He deserves to suffer.
Sean Lawson, Nevaeh's uncle, with emotions that are hard to contain.
I don't believe they should be allowed to live at all. I believe the maximum punishment should be applied to them, and they should get death.
Ready to see the person or people responsible punished for taking her. Still, though, family waiting on final autopsy results. A grandmother even ready to get involved herself.
Do you want to identify the body yourself?
Yeah, me and my son. I mean, we got to put closure to this, and I'm not going to know for sure if it's a little kid of somebody else's or what.
But sheriff deputies confident it likely is Nevaeh's body. Forensic pathologist Dan Spitz saying it may take time, maybe a week or longer, for DNA results to come back.
It's not necessarily a challenge in that it can be done, it will be done, it's just going to take some time. The other challenges are that the autopsy may be compromised to some extent, but I don't think that it's going to be compromised to the point of eliminating the determination as to the cause and manner of death.
We do want to wait till the DNA results do come back.
That could take some time.
Yes, and we waited this long. What's a few more days?
It's been a long 12 days so far. They say they still want to wait to hear the official word, the formal word, of course, of the DNA results. That, of course, determining that it may be that of Nevaeh Buchanan, the little girl, the body that was found just a few miles from here. In the meantime, I got to tell you, the folks here, they basically had all the pictures of Nevaeh that they posted all over Monroe County. Now those, not so much. Now what you're seeing is actually, instead of those, you're seeing postings saying whoever did this should pay with their life. Live in Monroe County, Roop Raj, Fox 2 News.